Right, shoulder one. First and foremost, before we get started, as always, we're going to give our praises about the name of number 2. Yahweh, by Hashem, Yahweh Shai, by Hashem, Rakhach. Also, double honors to the apostles and the elders of Great Millstone. Salutations to all you brothers out there. And there's a lot of stuff going on amongst Israel, which is, you know, very typical. You know, because every so often, you know, we'll have to deal with, you know, these false prophets. It is what it is, you know, it's a battle that's been going on from generation to generation, right? And it's nothing new in this time period. And, you know, we had this guy thinking of Cox, you know, he's the flavor of, you know, the week, 2 weeks, whatever it's been, right? But this guy said that we basically are talking about hell now, which that's false, right? Starting with the apostles on down, We have never talked that hell is your food place, or where you burn. You got a, you know, a little devil for a figure with a pitchfork stabbing you in your ass, okay? You know, that has never been taught. You know, these guys are really hurt. You know, their ego is getting, you know, crushed, basically. So they're just saying anything, okay? Anything and everything in their life, you know? See, these things are going to cease. All right, truth is going to prevail. Get that on real quick. The truth shall be established forever. I think that's how it's working. All right, it's like Proverbs 29. All right, because look, hey, that hypocritical tongue is only good for a moment. All right, it doesn't last forever. Let me see. No. Give me 1 second to bring it out. No. And this is, I'll say this though, it's just not Sakari though. You got other groups, you know, they have lied on us. And then ultimately, you're gonna have the biggest liar, the biggest hypocrite, which is Esau Edom. He's going to try to assassinate our character with lies and thought, you know, it just, you know, yeah, just lies, basically, right? Says the lip of truth shall be established forever, but a lying tongue is but for a moment. See? Because look, eventually the Lord, he's going to stop the mouths of these, you know, false prophets. Okay? Esau, Edom, these heathens. Look, truth is going to reign. Right? It's superior. You know? You know, hey, look, the scripture is saying in the book of Luke that what, all darkness shall come to light. You know? Look, you're bullshit when it comes to the light, all right? And it's going to get put on blast. Truth is always going to triumph. It's always going to overcome. It's going to rise to the top, you know? See, that's
it. It's because of the point that you said, the false prophets going to perish, man. This is Jeremiah 28. And 8, it says, the prophets that have been before me and before thee of old prophesied both against many countries and against great kingdoms of war and of evil oppressors. Jeremiah's neck and break it. Now I'm going to jump down to verse 17, which is the point. It says, so Hananiah the prophet died the same year in the 7th month. Why? Because even though you were a false prophet now for time, you talk all this, say all that, but at the end of the day, you're going to come to naught, as it says in the Acts 4 chapter. Because at the end of the day, hey, that land, lips, it's only for a moment. You can say this, you can say that, but it was your brother's blood too. The truth, that's going to stand. What's factual, what is the truth of the Lord is going to declare that. And then all the false people, the false doctrine, and the liars, and the deceivers, chiefly Esau, even drinking all down to even false prophets now, hey, they're going to be known to be what? Liars. The scriptures say our enemies are going to be found liars.
Remember, the elect is only one third of our, you know, of our nation. Okay, so these guys, they're gonna have a larger following. They're gonna have more, you know, positive comments, so to speak. Okay, you know, they're gonna get all the praise, right? You know, but see, the Lord doesn't care about numbers. He wants, you know, quality. You know, it's not about a quantity. It's about quality in the eyes of Yahweh Bashmi Al Shark. All right, see, that's one of the key things that these people forget about, all right, is the quality, the intent of the heart, you know? Is it pure? Is it, you know, righteous? See? All right, but I got this. This is Sirach chapter 51, verse 1. I will thank thee, O Lord, the King, praise the God of my Savior. I do give praise unto thy name, for thou art my defender and helper, and has preserved my body from destruction and from the snare of the slanderous tongue and from the lips that forge lies, has been my helper amongst my adversaries. Okay? You see, our poverty, how much we outside of the fight for us. Okay? You see, what can man do to us if we were on the side of Yahweh Shema Shah? That's in that book of Psalms, man. Alright? But it ain't nothing. Overcome us. Look, the elect have already overcome this present evil world. And that's because Yahweh Shai has overcome. Okay, what is that? In the book of 1 John, I think the fourth chapter talks about that. So whatever you do, it's going to come to nothing. All right? Yeah, I'll say this. You may get us fired, so to speak, right? Through your slander. You know, you may send, you know, videos of us preaching to our bosses, right? Hey, you know, you may, deliver me according to the multitude of thy mercies and greatness of thy name from the teeth of them that were ready to devour me, and out of the hands of such that sought after my life, and from the manifold afflictions which I had, from the choking of fire on every side, and from the midst of the fire which I kindled not, from the death of the belly of hell, from an unclean tongue, and from lying words. By an accusation to the king from an unrighteous tongue, my soul drew near even unto death. My life was near to the hell beneath. They compassed me on every side, and there was no help. So there was no man to help me. I looked for the support of men, but there was none. All right, let me see. Then I, let me keep reading. Then thought I upon the mercy of the Lord, and upon the acts of old, and how thou deliverest such as wait for thee, and savest them out of the hands of the enemy. All right, and you see, we're gonna be fine. All right, we're just waiting patiently. Look, we don't have to debate you. Okay, we don't have to get, you know, physical or carnal with you. You know, try to get into a fight with you guys. Look, the Lord's gonna do all these things, man. He's gonna justify us. And the scriptures talk about don't justify yourself. That's what we're gonna survive as well. We don't need to justify, you know, our actions and in our deeds, and you know what I'm saying? The Lord's gonna always prove us right, all right? See? But hey, you know what? And you guys are, you know, men of old that always came up against, you know, the apostles, the prophets, the elders, you know, that were set up by Yahweh, you know, God. Your Lord, your things, your things, Abraham, you know what I'm saying?
Our Lord, saying this, saying that, doing false accusations, misconstruing the words and not having a true understanding and then putting their own interpretation to make it sound wicked. That's what these people do. Why? Because they're wicked. Because they don't want to be with fool.
Because they're losing the spiritual battle. That's what it comes down to. Because you got to remember, this is a spiritual fight in the sense of the book of Ephesians, right? So since they're losing the spiritual battle, they got to fight dirty, right? Start, you know, throwing, you know, money dirty to some other guys. Take a chunk of his ear out, you know what I'm saying? You see, because that's what it is. That they're losing the fight. They're getting desperate, basically. Alright? So they're doing anything to get that victory. But look, you know, as we say, get how we've overcome the world, I think that's that first job. You know? Look, the elect, they're not going to lose. Alright? It's impossible. And how Hashem Yahweh Shai is on their side. They have a ready. All right? So no matter what you try to do, it's all in vain. But that's why I just want to talk about how man's mistake is all vain. Okay? And how man's thoughts are vain. And putting the Lord got a lying spirit on you, think that you're going to win. All right?
It's on 1 John 5 and 4. It says, for whatsoever is born of Yahweh, overcome the world.
Exactly. And basically, the elect, those first ones, all right? You see? They're the world of the heavenly Father. You know? So they're going to overcome.
Yeah.
See, right now, what does it say? It says in John 8:44, John 8:44 says that ye are of your father the devil. So two-thirds are really the lack of say this much, you're of the seed line of this also is one spiritual side. Right? What is he talking about the wheat and the tares? Your spiritual tares. Even though, yeah, what is it? All people not in the world. Yeah, you can say the lineage is us, you know, carnally speaking, right? Like we come from Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, right? One of the 12 tribes, you know? But you're really not of us, man. You know, we're cut from a different cloth, so to speak. See? If we are a part of the elect, and I believe God with the apostles on down, I believe these are the men of the Lord. Alright, no one's going to change my mind. Alright? The things that I've seen throughout these years, no other men have the same type of conduct. Okay? Yeah. Yahweh being the name of the Heavenly Father, and Yahweh Shai is whom this world ignorantly calls Jesus Christ, all right? See, we believe in the record. I think it's in the same chapter, or it might be the same. I know it's in the same book, for sure. All right? See, they don't really believe in the record. That's why they buck up so much. Oh, we don't have to pray to Yahweh Shai. The Apostle Paul's writing is not a poem. Okay? You know? So on and so forth. And then the gates open. They still want to be of this world. Okay? Look, if you come to serve Yahweh Shai, are you said it to the love of the Lord? Hey, you better obey his commandments. If you love me, you're going to keep my commandments. You're going to become that good man. You're not going to stay as the old man. You say all things are new. You know, when we basically follow Yahweh Shai, I know I'm butchering it. Yep. Okay? So you gotta put your flesh into subjection, okay? Your feelings, your emotions, because that's what it ultimately comes down to. It's you can't control your emotions. You know, a lot of guys get butthurt when they get rebuked by another man. A lot of the problem with our people, and then they got a father issue, okay? And that's what's in the curses, man. Alright, a lot of our men didn't grow up, you know, with a father in their household. Or even just, I'll say it's a male authority figure. Okay? They grew up with who? Their grandma, their mom, right, their aunties. You know what I'm saying? That's who they grew up around. Women. And women are what? Emotional. So that's how they are. And see, it's a psychological, they get a psychological damage. Alright? You see, They see this for the wrong reason. Women are head now. They take care of me. Then you gotta remember our women, they flex their bones, talk shit. You know they're down in their pops. Or any man, they're not even the cops. They're about to talk shit about their dad. You know what I'm saying? They talk shit about their dad, and now their mind. They have a problem with male food. And you see it, man. Look at all these young jakes out here. Completely cool, man. You can tell when somebody's had their father around, or maybe like a stepdad, or maybe they grew up around their grandfather, right? They have a whole different mindset and a whole different mannerism than those that grew up just around females. So point B though is these guys. They can't take rebuke and reproof from a man. Alright? It reminds me of, is that Absalom that did that? You got the counsel from the young man? Alright? During that whole situation, alright, you know, with Rehoboam, instead of him listening to the older men who've been around, who've been through some stuff, who have experience, who are wise. Instead of listening to them, basically he was listening to the little dirts, the King Bombs, alright? You know what I'm saying? The 21 Savages. You know what I'm saying? I'm just trying to use these as an example so you can get to them. That's really the problem, man. He took counsel from them, he took heed to what they're saying, instead of these men who are, you know, who have been living. But we've been doing it longer than they've been living. Alright? Same thing with these guys. Alright, they ignore it in that whole clique. They're listening to themselves instead of men. Trust me, Apostle Clark's been doing this longer than you've been living, fucking Elazar. You fucking Deacon Hakak. You guys are in your early 30s, man. Probably around my age. Apostle Clark's been doing this for 35 years. If not, they just want to go and you're going to destroy. Hey, you rebellious. Hey, scripture talk about this. The law, but you're not talking about the law so much. You're a Levitical priesthood. A rebellious child gets put to death. They get stoned, bro. And you know, that's all spiritual, man. Because you are getting stoned spiritually. By what? You know what I'm saying? by the men of the Lord with these, you know, with this word coming out, all right? And ultimately, that great millstone is going to stomp, right? All right? Which is at Yahweh Shah. You know? Sloppy, man. Hey, they just, bro, these guys are hurting, bro. But it's got to, bro, we've got to battle these guys, man. We've got to go back to them. I know eventually it's going to cool down, and then we're going to go back to, you know, prophesying, all right, about Russia and the U.S., you know what I'm saying, Israel, Iran, whatever, you know what I'm saying, about the, all the disaster that's happening in, you know, in Chicago, San Francisco, New York, L.A., you know what I'm saying, we still do it, but right now it's real heavy on these guys, man. Like, you got it.
First John 5 and 10. He that believeth on the Son of Yahweh hath the witness in himself. He that believeth not, Yahweh hath made him a liar, because he believeth not the record that the Most High gave of his Son.
You guys don't believe in the record, all right? The record, all of it, all right? From Genesis to Revelation. I don't care if you don't believe that, okay, in the book of Hebrews. I don't care, bro. I don't care if you don't believe in Paul's writings, you know, the epistles. I don't care if you don't believe in that, man. All right? That's on you, bro. Like I said, I don't even know what it's about. You're just, you said that you got to fight your locks, your Absalom locks. All right? You're upset about that. That's what it all comes down to. See, you know what's so funny? The Lord's still taking your locks away from you. You don't want to put it. Now you're gonna be real Greek then. Alright? You're gonna be real Greek. I mean, he wants to be Greek already. He's got the fitted iron on his arm. Okay? Alright? What I mean by Greek is that bald head. Alright, we talk shit about that all day in Chicago, bro. Alright? And that bald head be giving people fucking the demonic powers, bro. Look at MJ. Look at Kobe. Alright, Shaq, who else? Stone Cold. All right, that should be putting demons on Jake, bro. They just start elevating out of nowhere once they get that thing falling in. Movement. Oh, shit, bro. You know what I'm saying? All right? So you going to be Greek, man. Lord, you stripping that hair. You know? They take that cap off. Show the people.
Yeah, and it's really like, man, this is how you know he's wicked and rebellious. Because at the end of the day, we're not telling you to chop your shit off. He's bald. Because bald, it ain't got to be that long.
Chicago, it's cold, man. All right, we're not in one of them warm states, you know. We're not in, you know, Southern California. We're not in Texas. All right, Louisiana. Chicago, we get hit with that Arctic blast, man. And, you know what I'm saying? But eventually, you know, I'm going to get, you know what I'm saying? Start growing up, get a little trip. That's all you got to do. They even serve brothers, they got to pray.
That's the spirit of life. Isaiah 8 chapter 4.
Isaiah. You know, this song's 37:30. It's Isaiah chapter 8, verse 20. To the law and to the testimony, if they speak not according to this word, it is because there is no light in them. That's how you try the spirits. Okay? What are they talking about? So what are their deeds and their actions? You know? That's how you try the spirit. And you see, everything's going to get exposed. Whether it be a good or whether it be a evil, it's going to get exposed. Alright? It's going to get, you know, you know? Alright?
Psalms 37:30, the mouth of the righteous speaketh wisdom. Woo! His tongue talking of judgment.
Exactly. Right? And that's how you know a man of the Lord. It's really in their speech, man. I think that's what Sirach talks about. Even in this world, right? you have a child. In order for, I'll say it like this, you put them in what, sports, music, different activities so they're busy, so they don't start getting into the gang life selling dope, all right? So they're not fighting everybody, all right? The girls aren't going to fight every guy that they see, you know what I'm saying? So you put them in all these different activities so they don't have time to do wickedness, basically. The same thing with these guys, all right? Some random field and whatever, like some friends. And this dude's summoning up spirits, man. All right? Summing up these spirits, the point being what I'm trying to get at is they all had them books on, you know what I'm saying? They were all into, you know, fighting themselves, deceiving themselves. You know? You see? The point is, all that we're talking about, there's all this information coming out, but you still want to wear that goddamn hat, man. You still want to grow that hair up. All that.
Go!
don't know shit. You know some shit, but you don't know shit. You know? But you got it, Doc. Keep reading.
It says, Number says, living in his own self, covetous.
Yep, covetous. That's an important one because you all really want the preeminence. All right, really, you want your house shy. That's why you push for the bit of a reason so much. Right? Then everybody can go to the Levites in order to get their sins, you know, taken away, so to speak. Right? Because they were the mediator at the time. They were the ones who really, here's my coat, here's my turtle dove. You know what I'm saying? No, yeah, you do the sacrifice, now I'm clean. See? They still want that authority. But look, Yahweh Shai ended all. He was that ultimate sacrifice. You know? Okay, but you know, whatever. I'm not about to get too much into it. You guys probably want to go to the Yahweh Shai seat and then go down to this, you know, great men. They want the actual apostles' positions now, the elder bishops, the other elders amongst, you know, the body. You want their position. You want to be that guy, but you'll never be that guy. Look, you're going to be like a Jason, man. All right? Now, you're going to get your fame, but not in a good way. You know? And you're going to get he's that one that, if I'm not mistaken, right? The book of Maccabees. All right. Cool. Now what? You know what I'm saying? Now what? You said it. You guys got daddy issues, man. You guys are just weird, man. I gotta say, you're just fucking weird. What the fuck is wrong with you? Hey, there's no wrong with you guys like this. It is what it is. You've seen it all, man. You've seen it all throughout, you know, the U.S. You know what I'm saying? All these other people. You're throughout the world. I was gonna have a group of fucking
unthankful,
that's key right there. You're unthankful of the labors of the apostles, all right? Your spiritual fathers. Even the apostles out there, remember when they were fucking up against the whole situation with high priest already up? Like, that's demonic, bro. Like, you don't even know this man. You know what I'm saying? You don't know. Majority of the deep breakdowns that you have are from the elder high priest Ariah, man. What the hell, you know what I'm saying? You would know a chunk of the Bible if you didn't have this man being raised up by your home washing down shop. Fuck you, man. Fuck you. Keep reading out there, it's bad. It's wicked. But see, going back to what I said, they're going to get dealt with at some point. It's just going to be a matter of time. You know, one thing that, you know, then we fell out of the family. One thing that Mario used to say, it was a heavy statement, you people are living on borrowed time. You're living on borrowed time. It's only a matter, you know, time before we all come. And you guys are, through the spirit, man, see it close. A fall, right? You know, that pride's got to come in the middle. The other one's too close. The other one's got to get exposed. Just like Esau, right? Before his downfall, what? He said that he's got to, you know, basically get revealed. Some conditions got to get revealed. Same with you guys. You have to get exposed first before your destruction. And like I said, it's right upon the way. If you can't see it, hey, shit, man, you're a part of the problem too.
False accusers.
Like I said, they're saying that we believe in hell now, that we basically saying we've been pushing it the whole time. That's what you're basically saying. Like, what? Saying that our
merchandise, incontinent fears.
Incontinent basically goes into you having you can't control your desires, your lust. They very evil, you know?
It says fears despises of those that are good.
Yup. You hate that you never break those laws.
Traitors, enemies, high-minded, lovers of pleasures, or the lovers of the Most High.
Yep.
Having a form of godliness, but denying the power thereof, from such turn away.
Yeah, exactly. You guys have a form of godliness, but through your actions, your deeds, your words, you deny the true living power. Okay? It is evident. It really is. You know? You guys aren't unless you repent. If you repent, cool, bro. Like, you know, I'm not gonna be buddy-buddy with you, but you know, hey, I'll forgive you, you know? You know what I'm saying? Hey, I won't even bring any of this stuff up ever again. It's whatever, because it's in the past.
Oh, I'm not sure.